So we want to first of all thank you every sponsor joining us today. We have quite a bit of people to thank, and we really appreciate some of the vendors here, Liga Violin, Soto Violin, and we have Dexter Jones over there, representative, Paul Hart, Mr. Paul Hart is somewhere here, and we have the ASTA, American Strength Teachers Association, Yuna Chetta, Kienta Foundation, among others, Mr. Dennis Brimhall and Linda Brimhall, we also thank them, and also other donors that I haven't mentioned. But we are have 150 participants this year. It's like, you know, really special. Yeah, so, and some of you are still looking for the streaming. If you have family members who are trying to stream, you can go to the Facebook page. If you search on Facebook, DSU Cello Festival, you will find our page, and the links are all there. Or you can go on the music.tv LDT.edu, which is last cello festival and alert. You can also find the live stream information. So, our participants range from all the way from 3 years to 74 years old this year. From Utah, Arizona, Nevada, California, and one from Indiana. And we are excited that we have brand new beginners, and some of you met, or you're going to meet some of them and hear them play beautifully, as well as professional players and students and community members. And I think this is a great celebration community, and particularly this year we added to the deck of this festival, the Junior Festival, that I'm excited to have Peter Romney, Erica Hardy, and Emily Badarama lead this, and among others, parents helping this as well. And we also have the Grimm Hall cello competition that we feature some talents from different places to compete in the competition and be part of this. And this is the 6th anniversary of this cello festival. We especially celebrate Camille Saint-Saëns, French composer in the 19th century, 100th anniversary. So we'll play some of the works by Saint-Saëns. And just a little introduction about tonight's concert. There are four different groups going to play for you. They're all different people. We're going to start with the beginners. They call the ensemble Bravo because they're all fantastic people, Bravo, right? And after that, we will have the intermediate group, and then the two advanced groups. And on the left time, give it to the directors of the ensemble Bravo. Thank you for attending this concert. Enjoy.
And then we're also going to do a piece by Camille Saint-Saëns. It's the Dance Bacchanale. And I'm going to swap Mr. Candlin when we do that piece. So.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Dance Bacchanale by Camille Saint-Saëns will begin with a solo from Ethan Jones. Thank you. next to me two advanced groups featuring advanced players and professional players, cellists. And particularly, we are so excited to have our guest soloist, Tom Manchert, playing with us. The first piece you're going to hear is Allegro Appassionato by Camille Saint-Saëns, as we celebrate Camille Saint-Saëns' 100th anniversary. This piece is dedicated to Jules Lasselle as a virtuosic show piece. You're going to hear a lot of fantastic cello playing with the orchestra, a lot of interaction, sometimes like a question and answer and things like that. And then next in the program, that this group is going to play is the Piazzolla Winter from Four Seasons from Buenos Aires. And it's one of my favorite composers, Piazzolla. He combined uniquely Argentine tango music with jazz and classical influences. And the title that we're going to play is Winter because we all look forward to the mild winter in St. George, right? Anyway, but it's a beautiful piece, that's why. But then the next two pieces we're going to play by another group of advanced players. Then you're going to do the Comidera by Max Group. And for both the Allegro Passionato and Comidera, we'll feature the soloist. This piece is a Ramani declaration recited in Senegal and before the beginning of evening service on every Rome people. And this particular addition by Max Group is really beautiful with the conscious B section. And then last but not least, we will have Villa-Lobos. So we have Argentine composer, we also Brazilian composer. And feature this piece with a lot of Bach influences, originally for eight voice ensemble. So folk rhythm, beautiful harmony, and brilliant instrumentation. This is the ensemble, advanced ensemble. Without further delay, I'd like to welcome to you on stage soloist Professor Tom Manchert and conductor Scott McGlasman. fantastic to bring in guests onto us. So glad to have you. And at this point, I'd like to thank a lot of people. And we would not be successful without a lot of teachers, a lot of leaders, a lot of visiting guest artists and local artists with us. So if you are cello teachers and orchestra teachers and string teachers that you bring your students or yourself being part of, please stand. I'd like to recognize you if you are on stage or you are in the audience. Please stand. Yeah, teachers. Really, you know, take a lot of people to have this. And I'd like to thank all the participants and you guys all deserve because this 2 days are very intensive. They're here since Friday, and actually a lot of people come even the night before. And actually, the local coach also said they've been practicing for a long time. So kudos to all the students and all the participants and all the community members for being part of this. Thank you. I'd like to thank especially the volunteers, a lot of people that moving chairs and stands, and you know, and also those who feed them with food and arrange things, and also parents. Parents who bring in the students, you know, the Junior Festival, this year is new, we so appreciate all of you. So thank you everybody who was involved in getting this ready for this festival. Thank you. you once again for being with us today. This is great music. We actually have a lot for you. During the quarantine, during the pandemic, one song is beautiful and always played for the cello when they're at home. It's the Swarm Essence song. You hear a lot of videos of solo cellos playing that. You might even hear some cellos using toilet paper rope to play. And I've been playing like 100 cellos project doing it. And did you know that? But Swan is not a herd of swan. It's a bevy of swan, B-E-V-Y. And we have a bevy of swan here today. And, but I do like to dedicate this last piece, especially to those who have lost it once. And during this tough time, during a lot of whatever situation and family and or alone or loneliness or we love to get, you know, this is such a calming and peaceful piece. I like to dedicate to everybody because that's exactly what music has, and is to console and to share and to encourage. On the other hand, this is a hopeful piece as well, and we love to celebrate the community with this last song, last piece, and we look forward and to see you in Cello Festival 2022, and here is The Swan by Camille Saint-Saëns.